Hi there, Rudi here, and in this series of videos, we are going to learn about gallery design in Power Apps. We are going to do this example. Look at this gallery right here on my screen. The interesting thing about this gallery is that this gallery adapts to the width of the screen. What I mean by that is that if I resize my browser, if I resize the instrument, the browser, the screen that I'm using to play the app, the gallery will adapt to this new screen. Look at this. I will just resize to have a lower width, and then we can see that the gallery has the same width as the screen. Again, if I resize and increase a little, we can see that the gallery adapts. Also, we can see that the values are aligned with the headers. It doesn't matter the width of the gallery, they are always aligned. Another thing we can notice here is that when I decrease the width of my screen below a certain amount, the texts inside the gallery will also decrease its size, so it will fit better to the screen. Let's see, I will just decrease now, and we can notice that the texts are smaller, the fonts are smaller. And another thing, another curious thing, is that if I decrease even more, at a certain point, the gallery will stop adapting its width to the screen size, and then we are going to see this scroll bar here in the bottom. So we can see that we can now scroll to the right. In this case, the gallery is wider than the space that it's inside. So we are going to learn how to do all of this. How to make the text change the size, the screen, the width to adapt to the screen, and make this horizontal scroll bar to appear when the gallery is larger, is wider than the space that the gallery is inside. In order to do this, we'll need to learn about containers, very important, positioning of things, and also, what's the last point? Okay, I just remember also about the breakpoints, size breakpoints in Power Apps. Maybe you have never heard about that. Let me know in the comments if you know all those three, or if you are missing only one of them, or if you don't know any of those. Since they are all different and important topics, I'll separate the explanation in several videos and put in a playlist so you can watch sequentially. If you know one of them, you can just skip to the next video and go to the parts you think it's important. So let's get started, and I will put right now the first video where I'm going to demonstrate what's the data source behind this gallery, and I'm going to create the gallery just to connect to the data. So I see you in that video. Yeah.